views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned, because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show that's coming up right next.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail.
Hey, everybody. Super, super duper welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. Welcome to Transformation Talk Radio. Yep. Welcome to TransformationRadio.fm. And thank you all for tuning us in, turning us on. And many of you are saying, well, wait a minute. I'm not listening through that. I've got this other little Spreaker app or something on my phone. Well, yeah. So however you're listening to us, welcome to the show. It's great to have you here. We've got a great lineup for you today. Yep, because it's all about you. It really is all about you. But before it's all about you, let me say hello to Mr. Benny. Hello, Mr. B.
What's up? You said welcome to a lot of areas. I think welcome to life. If you're a newborn, welcome to the show,
life.
Too. I mean, this might be your first time out of the womb or doing whatever. There you go.
Right.
Welcome to the new life.
Welcome to the new life. Benny's got it. That's a new radio show for Benny. I love
right.
that. Welcome to the new life. That is very, very cool. And by the way, speaking of new life, how do boys?
They're good.
Yeah, they're big.
Yeah, they're getting there. I have twins, if you haven't noticed or heard from me already. They'll be
You haven't
five.
Heard from him because he has twins.
Yeah, exactly. There'll be five in January, and they're sprouting like little weeds. And
wow.
Man, it's amazing to see personality of like pretty much me now in one of them, and then the personality of when I was younger growing up in the other.
Wow.
But then the next day it flips.
It's
great.
Does it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's so that you stay keep you on your toes.
It really does.
It has to keep you on your toes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How fun is that? Have you taught him how to throw a softball yet?
We've done a little bit. We took some classes, you know, just like a little pre-K type class. Like that. They're into it for like 30 seconds, and then they just run around and try to tackle each other. So that's how pretty much
okay.
it works.
Yeah.
Try to wrangle them up and
wow,
get them focused
that...
again. Then they tackle each other again. And
well,
this isn't
Isn't that
football
cool?
Either.
The football twins.
But they're not football. This is like softball and baseball or basketball. You don't tackle basketball.
It depends on where you play
this
softball, right?
This is true.
Okay, good.
Or any sport for that.
I know, totally. Well, you know, we have a great lineup for all of you today. It is really exciting to, you know, step up and take a breath of air in the world today. And many of you think about your lives and you think, I don't really have a purpose. I don't really know what I'm going to do. You know what? I got to tell you. Sometimes the purpose in your life isn't necessarily what you think it's going to be. You know, sometimes your purpose, like me, is like selling hot dogs. That was my purpose once in my life, to sell hot dogs from a hot dog cart. Very good. It was a good. I love that. I love that job. Another time it was to clean fish, to do that. Another time it was to push a mail cart in a mail room. But whatever you decide to do in life, you know, the thing to remember is to do it fully. You know, to step into the world and do it fully. And how do you do it fully? Well, one of the things that you get to do is you get to learn along the way. And, you know, we have someone joining us right now that knows a lot about helping people learn along the way. You know, Ginny Rutherford is joining us here today, a certified transformational life coach. She is, she is out of the Seattle area. But what we know about coaching now is you are not limited by the borders or the boundaries of where you live anymore. And so when we think about, you know, what it means to stand in your yes, we think about someone like her, about how her life has taken the turns that it's taken, how she stepped in to being an alchemical tarot expert in that field, and how she helps give her clients insight into what their next steps are going to be. Or if you're her, maybe you do it in the jungle of Peru. Very cool thing to do. But, you know, what is it about her life now? What is she now embarking upon to now even more help others experience what it's like to raise their own level of consciousness from within and say yes to a bigger world? Today, you're going to hear about something incredible. The title of the show is The Kiss of the Frog. And I'm not even going to tell my frog joke today. Ginny, welcome to the show. It's great to have you here.
Thanks, Dr. Pat. And can I just say this one thing?
Yeah.
Holy cow, I'm on the Dr. Pat show. I need to pinch myself a little bit. If I'm dreaming, don't wake me up because this is awesome.
Well, let's talk about that. You know, I didn't talk about what we were going to talk about today because I always love to have the folks that have created something talk about it from their own perspective. I want to ask you, since you are here, and I know what it's like to be on air for the first time. I never forgot that. I never did forget, you know, that first time getting behind a mic. It was like coming home in an arena that I knew zero about. But for you, tell me a little bit about what some of the challenges, obstacles you had to clear out of the way so you could, like, be here right now.
Wow. Well, that would be a long story because there's a lot of challenges
We can skip the break.
Awesome. Well, really, about 10 years ago, I was getting of an age where I decided I needed to start looking at my life and saying, is this the way I want my life to be? And I think I'd spent a lot of my life playing it safe. I grew up in a very religious household. My grandfather was a minister. He was like a Southern Baptist minister. And so I had all these belief systems and really very rigid about how I lived my life. And I got to this age where I thought, this can't be all there is. And so I started looking at, well, what most people would call a bucket list. I always call it my wheelbarrow list because there was so much in there that I had just left it all behind and really not doing the things I felt like I wanted to do for my life and living an exciting life. So I went on this voyage of taking all of my belief systems that kept me stuck or imprisoned or kept me from living a full life. And one by one, I started facing them. And the first thing I did was I smoked a cigarette for the first time. I had never smoked a cigarette. And I know that seems like a small thing, but in our walk, the small things count. And I had a huge belief system around that good girls don't do that and that you were a bad person if you smoked. And so I tried a cigarette for the first time. Of course, as you know, the universe kind of has its little fun with us sometimes. The next day, I woke up with pneumonia for 10 days.
You know, so, I was just going to say, right? You know, there's usually a tagline to a story like that, right?
There always is. Yeah. So I was like, you know, that inner voice is saying, okay, now look what you've done. You know, is this what you want for yourself? You keep doing that kind of stuff, and this is what's going to happen. But really, that deeper inner voice said, yes, this is what you have to do. You have to start challenging all those things you've been told that were right or the way to live your life. And that's what I continue to do. So I've done a lot of things just in a way of facing my fears.
Well, tell me about Peru, because many of us, you know, we've been out in various forms of vision questing and, you know, certain traditions. You know, I spent quite a bit of time in the high desert of California, you know, with the many indigenous rituals and traditions. Tell us about what the draw was to Peru and what your experience was like. How did it change you?
Well, I would say that was my hero's journey, and I had no intentions of ever going to Peru. That was not in my wheelbarrow list. Never even thought about it, never gave it a thought. But one morning, about a year and a half ago in September, I woke up about 4 a.m. with a voice saying, you're going to Peru. And I opened my eyes and start looking around to see who said that. And then I realized it was in my head. And I started laughing like, I'm not going to Peru. There's no way I'm going to Peru. I never wanted to go to Peru. Not on my list. I'm not going to Peru. But what happened is I laid down to start to go back to sleep as I remember hearing a TED Talk that's now been banned that Graham Hancock gave on the war on consciousness. And he talked
let's talk about that because that's kind of interesting.
It is.
That a talk would be banned.
Yeah.
I understand that we do some of that, but why do you think that was from your perspective? Because honestly, originally you listened to it.
Yes.
Right? There was a draw to it.
Yes.
What do you think that was really about?
The ban?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think in our culture, without sounding too conspiratory, our powers that be do not want us to wake up, and they don't want us to expand our consciousness because that's where our freedom lies.
No
and,
kidding.
Yes. And so I think that was the politics of it, is that he was talking about that we have, we should have sovereignty over our own consciousness. And if we don't have that, we really don't have anything.
Yeah.
And so that's why they banned it.
You know, it's really interesting. And I know that you're probably wondering, how is this related to what we're talking about today? But it is related.
It is.
I know Benny and I did a recording. You know, he graciously allowed me to record a few things before the show about what, you know, what we're on the verge of launching. And, you know, it is really clear to me that there were probably going to be people that look at what we're doing and be completely insulted that we dare to launch a network that has both God Talk Radio and Psychic Talk Radio on the same network. For somebody like me, it makes perfect sense.
Me too.
Right? But being banned for a point of view is a little extreme. How did that, though, motivate you to become self-empowered?
Well, after I... after I woke up that morning, I decided to go back and listen to that again, because mm-hmm. the first time I heard it, which had been about a year before then, I was mm-hmm. mildly interested, but mm-hmm. that was it. And so, but that came to my mind. And as I listened to it the second time, it was with a different mind.
Mm-hmm.
And I began to wonder, so what would it be like to go to Peru, and what would ayahuasca tell me? And what would how would the experience be with the shamans? And I had a great deal of fear about it, but in the same respect, I had some excitement about it. So I began to think about the possibility of maybe considering going to Peru. And so 2 months later, I went to Peru. And that was, again, a hero's journey. I had to face so many of my fears.
Yeah.
But it was transformative, and there is nothing like that hero's journey to change us.
I know. And, you know, part of that is, out of something like that, you know, Ginny, you get to create, you know, something that is helping people. Now, we're going to talk about it when we come back. You know, what is it about what we're learning about natural medicine, which is some of which, most of which is really ancient in time? You know, what are we really learning now? And you want to talk about a war that's going on. You know, there's a battle going on for us to fight for our rights for natural medicine care. And, you know, we're running into and running out of time to really have a say in whether we choose this drug or this natural drug, you know, if I could use the term, this natural remedy. And it's being, people are being, I don't know if, well, you didn't hear me, but part of what I was talking about had to do with the doctors that are losing their license for treating, you know, chronic Lyme disease naturally. Thank goodness in the state of Washington, we have a little bit more going on here, so that doesn't happen. When we come back, Ginny's going to talk with us about the kiss of the frog. What does that really mean? And about a traditional medicine used by Native people in the Amazon. What is it? What are the secrets behind it? And how can we now tap into those secrets? Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the show.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Would you like to be a question with anything that comes up in your body or mind? Would you like to become totally aware and begin to function as the conscious being you truly are? Join Access Certified Facilitator Glenna Rice every month for a live teleclass where you can ask all of your questions and learn to create change in any aspect of your life. Visit GlennaRice.com today to learn more, and don't miss the next call. Join the questionable conversation today at GlennaRice.com.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Naturopathic doctor, founder of the Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat, and author of the New York Times bestseller 21 Pounds in 21 Days, Dr. Ronnie DeLuce has helped tens of thousands of people, including celebrities and athletes, with her message of lifestyle change. Now Dr. Ronnie DeLuce wants to help you. You too can be saved. Email Dr. Ronnie DeLuce at info@ronniedeluceonradio.com and visit mvholisticretreat.com. Dr. Ronnie DeLuce, your partner in wellness.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Great to have you join us here. Tune us in and turn us on. It's so great to be introducing all of you to Ginny Rutherford. And, you know, we're going to talk a bit now, well, quite a bit now, about, you know, how this journey of hers took her on, you know, maybe not the long and winding road, but the road to come to a place where, you know, she's gotten to know not only who she is, but who she wants to be in the world. Before the break, we were talking about your journey into Peru, and as well as, you know, what it's like to step out into the world and talk about something you're passionate about, but more importantly, something that's going to help other people. You made that discovery for yourself. Tell us about what that was like and why the kiss of the frog.
Yes, I love the story of the kiss of the frog, because what happened when I was researching going to Peru, I came across some other medicines, and one of them was this frog medicine. And I saw a BBC documentary about Bruce Perry getting this frog medicine. And when I first saw it, my reaction was like, holy cow, I am never doing that. That is just crazy stuff. And I had this real resistance to it. And a year later, so at the beginning of this year, I woke up one day just so excited about the new year and what it was going to bring me. And I was in my thoughts about, you know, all these wonderful things. And this thought came into my head, you have to do Cambo. And my first reaction was like, what? I am not doing Cambo. But I've kind of learned over time that when I have these great resistances, those are the things that really my soul is longing for.
Right.
And so I sat down and started researching, where can I do Cambo? And I found a wonderful master practitioner in Topanga Canyon, and his website was called Cambo Cleanse, and his name is Simon Scott. He is one of the only master practitioners in the U.S., and so I immediately contacted him and set up 3 days to go do Cambo. And so what Cambo really is it is this sweat that comes from the Amazonian frog. And what happens is there's a legend around it that a shaman in his village, all the people were sick. Now, on energetic levels, they had lethargy, bad luck, depression, and he did not know how to help his people. And so what he did was he went out into the forest and drank ayahuasca to get information. And so what happened is that this great god showed up with a frog in its hand and showed him how to collect the sweat, the secretion of the frog, and how to administer it to his people. And his name was Kampu. And so that's what he did. And everybody healed in his tribe. And so when he passed away, the legend is that his spirit went into the spirit of the frog. So that's just kind of the backstory on Kambo. But they still use this in the Amazon to get rid of what they call panema. And panema is like the lethargy of the energetic body. And they still use it. So it's a beautiful thing.
Well, you know, let's talk about this for a minute, because many of you may not know this, but, you know, if you look at, you know, animal totems and you look at the medicine totems, the frog is the totem of cleansing.
It is.
Right?
Yes.
And so, I mean, and that knowledge goes way back. But I think we lost track, though, of why. Right?
Yes.
I mean, it's like, you know, we could have moved forward to understand the power of that. But, you know, we're faced in a world where we went through the industrial age, we went through the pharmaceutical age, which we're in now. And so anything that even looks or feels or sounds or smells like that is not going to come to the forefront. What is it about your discovery that excites you most?
Well, what excited me the most is after my Kambo experience. And so there's a way in which it is done that, you know, is a little scary to people, because what they do is, the way the shamans do it is they sing, they catch the frogs, they kind of sing to them, and then they kind of stretch them out and tie some little vines around their legs, and then they sing to the frog and it sweats its poison, so to speak, its toxin. And then they scrape that off onto a paddle, and then they have to let the frog go, and they have to be very careful. This has to be done very in a sustainable way, because to harm the frog is like to bring really bad luck and karma to you. So they are very careful to do that. And the beautiful thing is that though science has tried to study this, they cannot get the frog to sweat in the laboratory. So I think that's a really awesome thing. So
frog's pretty smart.
The frog is very smart, has a lot of... And this frog actually has no natural enemies. Even the boas will not... They'll try, you know, if they try to swallow it, they're trying to get it out very quickly. So there is no natural enemies. And the spirit of that underneath is what we feel also when we are taking the Kambo, is that there's no natural enemies there. It is really a helpful drug.
So tell us about it. What have you learned about the properties of it? And, you know, and how has it evolved here in the U.S.?
Well, it's just starting to evolve in the U.S. Not many people have heard of it, but I think... Well, I know as time goes on, more and more people are going to hear about it. And so what they say when you do the Kambo, what the shamans say is that it circulates in the heart and it recalibrates the heart to beat with the heart of the universe. And so it feels like everything just flows. And that was exactly my experience after doing the Kambo, is I felt like everything came easy, that I had no blocks. It was just like I was in the flow of things. And that is such a great feeling. And the other thing that that it really does is it goes in and it kind of helps us to remove those blocks so that we can actually look at the things inside of us, because we sometimes know our life isn't working for us, but we don't know how to fix it.
Right.
Because we can't even really see it.
Right.
And so this kind of removes those blocks so we can see those things that we need to do for ourselves. And that is really helpful. I find that to be one of the most helpful parts of this medicine.
How, you know, when we talk about this, really, I mean, it's just really a question mark of educating and informing, you know, when we're looking at this, you know, at a physical level, and let's do that for a moment, you know, what have you discovered in terms of its physical healing properties?
That's a great question, because how I experienced it, I had a lot of issues with, I was having some digestive issues and food allergies before I had gone, and I was really had been working on it for about 9 months, trying to manipulate my diet and everything that I was doing. And what I found after doing the Kambo is that really healed a lot, and I felt much better. My digestive system just works much better now. I also found I had a lot more energy.
Mm-hmm.
I just had a better, more general feeling of health. And because this goes into the lymphatic system, it really boosts our immune system.
Right.
So when I came back, everybody was sick with that terrible flu going
around.
Right,
yeah.
I was hanging around with all those people, and they were all like, don't stay away. And I'm like, I wasn't worried about it.
Wow.
And I didn't get any of that. So in the jungle, they call it a vaccine, and that's what they use it for.
Wow. I mean, isn't it really interesting that we don't even understand the right questions to ask about this? Because we're so used to not having something as natural and as simplistic in the whole idea even makes sense to us, right? But when you think about that, when you think about the Amazonian frog and what that frog experiences, right, in its natural habitat, it would make perfect sense. It would make perfect sense that it would develop something like that in order to not just survive, but, you know, thrive in that environment.
I agree. It has really no natural enemies.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it does thrive very well.
That's really hard to even imagine.
It is. It's very difficult. I would say that probably the only predator it has is man.
Mm-hmm. And what are you seeing, though, in terms of your journey in introducing people to this? What are you really hoping for here?
Well, once I experienced the Cambo and I went to two different ceremonies a month apart, I knew immediately that this was going to be my path. And part of what Cambo does is it gives us great clarity to move forward with our life. And I just knew it. I didn't even question it. So I went about researching that. There is an International Association of Cambo Practitioners where you can actually do the training.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to be doing that. I'm leaving July 2nd for 14 days in Poland to actually go through that process of doing the practitioner training.
Wow. We're going to take a short break, though. But when we come back, we're going to talk about what people are experiencing, you know, why this has gotten your interest and the interest of so many people. And, you know, how does it help us beyond the physical level? Also, we're going to make sure we give out your website and find out how folks are going to be able to find out more about this. We're going to take a short break, everyone. When we come back, we're going to give you lots of information. We're going to talk about, you know, is this safe? There is this idea out in the world that, you know, natural remedies for things may or may not be safe. Well, that's kind of an interesting notion. All you need to do is read a label of some of our mainstream prescriptions. But why do we have such stigma about this? And how do you go about this in a way that does not cause any harm? Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the show.
In retirement, will you have enough money to live life on your terms? Everyone has retirement questions. Ask Ameriprise Financial Advisor Jeff Packman about the new Confident Retirement Approach. You and Jeff can break down retirement planning step by step to get the real answers you need. In fact, 93% of clients who've had the Confident Retirement Approach conversation feel more confident about their retirement. Call Jeff Packman Financial Advisor at 425-453-0272 for your Confident Retirement conversation today. Office is located at 601 108th Avenue Northeast, Suite 1800, Bellevue, Washington, 98004. Percentage based on Ameriprise Financial Confident Retirement Client Survey as of December 2013. The Confident Retirement Approach is not a guarantee of future financial results. Investment advisory products and services are made available through Ameriprise Financial Services Incorporated. A registered investment advisor, Ameriprise Financial Services Incorporated, member FINRA and SIPC.
I'm Peggy Snow with another Stellar Reflections Minute. Presence, or what we think of as being fully in the moment, is a key element in the process of healing work. As a practitioner facilitating a session, genuine presence takes us out of our heads, where we tend to decide what is and maybe what should be for the client, and moves us into direct experience where we're available to witness the person in their wholeness. In this receptive realm, our senses are heightened and expanded, allowing us to perceive what's seeking to unfold and to interact in the moment. There's something profoundly powerful that happens when healing is approached in this simple, pure way. Balance can be restored and healing can take place on multiple levels. If you'd like more information about the services we offer at Stellar Reflections, visit us at stellarreflections.com or call 425-999-9836. That's 425-999-9836.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Froggy jumped all over the stage that day. Froggy jumped all over the stage that day. Rolling Stone magazine sucked him dry and made him king. Froggy let rip with a big burp and Froggy jumped all over the stage.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Nice, Benny. Oh, man. Welcome
local
back.
Artist, too, by the way. That's
really?
Presidents of the United States of America.
Wow, nice. Yeah.
Chris,
wow.
Chris Ballew and all those guys.
You're so on top of it. I love that. Ginny, it's so great to have you here. You know, most of this, you know, most of the time we get to introduce people to some amazing healing and cleansing solutions. And it's so great to have you here talk about something that very few people know about. And you're going out in the world in a big way to really introduce this to people. So for those of you out there, well, first of all, if you have any questions, give us a call, 1-800-930-2819. But also, tell us how people can find out more. And then I know you're doing an upcoming workshop. So tell us about the workshop and what that's going to be able to reveal for people.
Yes, I'm very excited about this workshop. It's the first time we're bringing Simon Scott, the master practitioner, up here to do this workshop. It's June 13th, 14th, and 15th. And I'm very excited about it. I put it out on the on my Facebook page, Cambo Kiss, and immediately I only have two more openings. We had 20 spaces, and I have two openings left. We will be doing it again in September. But it is very exciting because people know inside themselves that there are other ways of doing things. And we're just they're tired of the same old thing, pushing, you know, pills that don't really help us. And they're looking for something else. And people are looking to expand their own journeys. We feel these blocks inside of ourselves. So, you know, thoughts, ideas, beliefs, they're often big obstacles for the expansion of our consciousness. And these plant medicines and the frog medicines, they have an intelligence about them so that they can work within. I mean, we work together. And so they can help us do that expansion. We can take on that energy and that intelligence. And I just think it's my calling to do that for people because we can struggle through this and fight it and go to battle against all these, you know, because basically we want to be better.
Yeah,
we want
to
do better.
We do.
But once we take up that to, I want to be better, that's the fight. We already start a fight and then we have to use only our willpower. And that never works very well. It's a really difficult way to go. And so what happens with these plant medicines, the frog medicines, is that it just comes naturally. Yeah. We don't have to use our willpower. We don't have to fight to make those changes in ourselves.
Right. And less is usually more. You know, we're so used to that not being the case. I mean, anybody that's been on any medication for any period of time, you know, myself included, you know, it's not less is more. It's usually more is more.
That's really the way it works in our...
You know, and a little bit goes a long way.
Yes.
So tell us about the workshop. I know you're almost filled up. How can people register? I know you may have a couple of seats left.
We do.
We
have a couple of seats left, so they can go to www.cambocleanse.com.
K-A-M-B-O.
K-I-S-S .com. And all the information's on there. There is a PayPal button so you can go on and actually register. And then we'll send out a packet to you telling you how to prepare, where it's going to be located, and what you need to bring.
And so tell us about what you're going to cover in the workshop. And, you know, I know that there's stories that have been told about what, you know, this natural solution has been able to do for people. What are some of the ideas? What are some of the things that you've heard about or have seen?
Well, this resin from the frog sweat contains 18 peptides, which our body needs. And they are analgesic and they strengthen the immune system. So they provoke destruction of these pathogenic microorganisms. And so this has an antibiotic property to it. Huh. So a lot of people have found that, and even in the research, that these antibodies, they are showing great power in the treatment of Parkinson's and AIDS, cancer, depression, and other diseases. So even though the two main peptides, which is dermorphine and deltorphine, they are synthetically produced in pharmaceutical laboratories, it's just not the same as it is coming directly from nature. Because always that synthetic stuff gets, there's an intention behind it and an energy behind it, and it gets manipulated and kind of changed in the process.
Yeah, but we wouldn't be talking about this if we didn't have some results that people were experiencing.
Definitely.
Certainly the indigenous people. I mean, we're talking about folks that rely solely on what is in their environment, what they find, the herbs, the plants, and actually what's happening in the rainforest is horrific. Cutting down the rainforest is so beyond anything that I can even imagine. But, it's we pray that, divine wisdom will, result over there. Well, but what are some of the stories that you've heard?
Well, really, why the shaman now are bringing these plant medicines out to the Western world is because they know that if the Western world does not wake up, this house of cards is going to collapse.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to wake up to that. And so one of the stories I love to tell, when I was in the jungle, our shaman took us out into the rainforest and showed us a tree. And he said, this tree is used to cure AIDS. But what the pharmaceutical companies do is they give little doses and spread it out over a long period of time so that they can make more money, of course. Whereas if you went to the jungle for 30 days and used this tree bark, you would be cured of AIDS very quickly. So that's, the shaman and the indigenous people just, they think it's just crazy that a lot of these illnesses that we suffer from could be cured so quickly. And in our culture, we suffer with them for a long period of time just based on greed and making more money.
Well, and, the shamans are coming out because they're actually seeing right in front of us, millions of different solutions for various things disappearing forever. I mean, if it wasn't for their knowledge and wisdom of passing this on, we wouldn't be having this conversation here today, right?
That's true. And a lot of the tribes, the younger people now, because the oil drilling and the logging, they're going and working for these companies, and not the tradition is not being passed on. And so what's happening is a lot of what they call gringos are going down, and they're living in the jungle with these shamans, and this wisdom is being passed on to the Western world in that manner, which, that's awesome, because we get to experience that where we may never even have known about it. So I think that's a positive thing in some respects. But what also happens with this medicine, particularly the Camba, is that it actually detoxifies the liver.
Well, and let's talk about that for a minute, because there are many different theories about the role the liver plays, not just in, in terms of how we attract diseases, but also if we are here in this country and we are plugged into now conventional medicine and pharmaceuticals, the liver and the toll that these medicines have on the liver, if nothing else, what you're talking about is a substance, a natural substance that could detoxify. So we're not putting more strain on our body, right?
Definitely. And it's true. I mean, everyone I talk to who have gone and have liver studies, everybody's liver is not functioning properly because of the toxins that we have to try to deal with every single day.
Yeah, even in what we breathe and,
even in the air around us. Yeah. So it's really difficult. So having something that detoxifies the liver so quickly and so easily
Let's talk about easily for a moment,
yes.
Because this is really that we don't usually talk about quickly and easily, especially in terms of natural medicine. You know, what is it about the easily part? Because most people, when they think about natural medicine, they don't say quickly and easily. But that really is because we're really not pulling in the power and potential of these remedies in their purest form. This is, we're talking about the purest form right here.
Absolutely. And
yeah.
Even in some of the natural remedies that are out there, you know, in natural health, even they kind of miss the mark because, again, they're still, they're part of that pharmaceutical culture. But what these natural medicines do is they, for me and how I look at it, is they go right to the heart of the matter. So it's almost like these medicines scan your body and go right to where it needs to go.
Yeah, I know.
And then takes care of it.
Wow.
Instead of hit and miss and let's try this natural medicine, let's try this, and we're just keep trying things and hoping it works. And this goes to the heart of the matter very quickly.
It's got to be amazing for you to be on the journey that you're on and sort of watching how powerful taking a message like this is into the world, right? I mean, because most of the time we sort of sit on the sidelines and we don't think we can have a role. You know, like we don't think we could ever play a role or have a part. But for you, you're playing a big part.
True, and not what I thought I would be doing, for
right,
sure.
Right, exactly. No kidding, right?
No,
I mean,
not at all.
Yeah, I know that feeling pretty well.
Yeah, I mean, I always think about you and you made a phone call and it was a wrong number.
Wrong number.
In some respects, I feel a little bit like that same
right.
thing, like, what's going on here?
It's
happened so quickly, and it's as though, you know, really the universe is just conspiring to make it all happen. So I feel like I'm playing catch-up.
Right.
Like just trying to catch up to what the universe is opening up towards.
Yeah, because you know what? Someone said it a long time ago. I have a friend that really believes in the four blood moons. We're coming up on the fourth now. That's going to happen. And, you know, I've done a number of shows about this. But we're coming up to the last one in September. And, you know, he literally believes that the level of transformation and abundance around this is really ushering in enormous waves of shifts and changes. And, you know, this is really the time for people to emerge to help other people. And that's what you're doing. I really commend you on that. I really do. Because, you know, you're here because you said yes.
That's exactly right. I said yes. And I could have said no, because we have that free will to say no.
Yeah.
But sometimes when people tell me, oh, I'm afraid to do this. And I was afraid to do it, too. It's not like I don't have any fear. It's just that I don't let that limit my life. And if I would have said no, this wonderful journey that I am on, and believe me, this is like the most exciting journey of my life, I would have missed out on. So just the act of letting go of my fear and pushing back past that, because, you know, fear really keeps us from moving forward.
Oh, my gosh. You know, and let's talk about this when we come back. Let's talk about the spiritual aspect of this. Because many people have asked me, you know, what was it like going out in the desert and doing it multiple times and then being part of, you know, the council, you know, the spiritual council to take other people out. And there aren't words that I can describe. I mean, I don't journal as a habit, but on these occasions I have. And I went back and I found my journal from my first vision quest and I read it. And it's almost like you're having an out-of-body experience, right?
Definitely.
Because here you and I are today, but we weren't that in the experience of it. When we come back, I want to talk about the spiritual nature of this and how symbolic the frog is in cleansing and why it is so important for us now to get spiritually clean. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side?
Rainbows. Hello, my name is Dr. Friedman Schaub. Negative self-talk plays a major role in how we create fear and anxiety. You're probably familiar with that worried, insecure, or critical voice that rises from somewhere deep inside, often at the most inopportune moments. You don't seem to choose the limiting, anxiety-triggering, or self-sabotaging thoughts, nor do you seem to be in control of them. Over the years, I've found that rather than ignoring or suppressing these negative thoughts, what works best is to redirect the mind with at least three counterbalancing arguments that shed light on the opposite, positive points of view. For example, if your negative thought was something bad will happen, counterbalances could be, right now I'm okay. There have been many times I was worried and everything turned out well. I have the strength and abilities to handle anything that comes my way. Positive counterbalancing is training your mind to search for and find uplifting and empowering perspectives for any given situation.
Wondering how to play the game of life and actually win? Stop wondering and start willing the game of life with the unique and incomparable Lynn Brown. As an intuitive healer and experienced business manager, Lynn can help you live your life to its full potential. To learn more about Lynn, visit ruintuit.com. That's the letter R, letter U, intuit.com.
Welcome to Smile Big, nominee of Seattle's Top Dentist Awards. Here at Smile Big, we offer restorative, cosmetic, and preventative dentistry. Some of our regular dental services include tooth-colored fillings, crowns, bridges, implants, bleaching, cosmetic bonding, and complete smile restoration. Dr. James Rosenwald and Dr. Susan Aptener won't be smiling until you are smiling. Call now to schedule a visit with Seattle's Top Dentists. Our number is 425-454-4040. You can even visit our website at smilebig.com.
Called the Oprah of radio by her listeners, award-winning host Dr. Pat Basile is blowing the doors off of traditional talk radio. Get ready for an energizing delivery and powerful interviews with leaders in the field of human potential. Dr. Pat's fresh, new perspective on living life full out has catapulted her show to the top of talk radio. Tune in and Dr. Pat will help you thrive instead of merely survive. Visit thedrpatshow.com. That's thedrpatshow.com for listening times in your area.
Illusions and rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong way.
That's right. Many of us have been kissed by frogs. As a matter of fact, I think I was in a 14-year relationship with one. That's a whole nother show. Ginny Rutherford joining us here today. I'm really excited to be introducing all of you to not just what we're talking about, one thing is to talk about the natural remedy that we're talking about today, but it's another thing to talk about Ginny. And it's another thing to talk about, you know, what it was in her life that enabled her to say yes. And that is a big part of the story, which, you know, you'll hear more about. But many of us jump into service and we don't talk about what our calling is all about and why this is really now something she is passionate about and wanting to help others. If you don't mind, one more time with the website and again with the workshop and how people can find out more. But I think many people are going to want to know, wow, how can I get some of this?
Exactly.
Right? I mean, it's going to be, okay, this. How do I get it?
Yes. Well, again, the workshop is June 13th, 14th, and 15th. And you can go to my Facebook page called Cambo with a K-A-M-B-O, KISS. Or you can go to my website, www.cambokiss.com, and it'll have all the information on there for you to register. So we still have a couple of spots left. We'll be doing this again in September, and Simon Scott, again, will be coming back up. I'll be actually working under him for a few months before I'm going to be going to the jungle in November for a month.
Wow.
To live with the shamans and do my initiation and Daita, and so taking on the spirit of the Cambo medicine.
And, you know, that is the part of the conversation that I'm really looking forward to having right now. You know, there is a spiritual part to this. I mean, the whole idea about the way Indigenous folks have really honored their environment is something that, boy, we could learn a lot from. You know, and honoring the environment and honoring nature is a spiritual path.
Yes. So we have all these separations. You know, we are, there's the four aspects of who we are. We're that intellectual, we're the emotional, the spiritual, and the physical. And we have a tendency to get caught up in one of those aspects. Like in our culture right now, we are definitely caught up in the intellectual aspect of it, because that's what makes our culture work on that linear, rational, get stuff done level. When you go into the indigenous tribes, they are much more balanced in all of their bodies. And so they understand, like they dance and they laugh and they, party hardy kind
right.
of sort of thing. And they love the nature. They are in harmony with the nature. So not in a way like we kind of go off to this other direction. Sometimes we're going to, save this and save that. They understand that for the frog, it's giving up its gift to the world. And so they honor that. The same with the plants when you're using ayahuasca. It's giving up its wisdom to the world. And so they have a great deal of respect for this. Mm-hmm. There is a huge spiritual component. So it's all done in ceremony, where we have lost our ability to do ceremony.
Yeah, we really have. Yeah, we really have. And, part of this also is remembering what ceremony is. I mean, growing up as a kid, and, this is something that is really worth mentioning. We often think to ourselves that, no, I didn't grow up with that, but we have grown up with it. We had rituals even around an Italian, dinner table.
Exactly.
There was ceremony of a sort. And we are finding now that there is a hunger and a longing to bring ceremony back and bring it back in a contemporary way. But part of the spiritual journey is equally as important to the actual medicine itself, isn't it?
I think that is the whole point, is the spiritual part of this. What they do, what the main purpose of this frog medicine is to actually balance our energetic
mm-hmm.
body.
Mm-hmm.
Now, all the other things that it does on the spiritual level, on the mental level, and the emotional level are just, to me, like it's the cherry on top.
Right.
But the main purpose of this is to actually balance out that energetic body and get rid of those blocks that we all carry in our energetic body.
Right. And we do carry them. And, part of this is also looking at the whole idea of cleansing and what the frog stands for, right? We're talking about cleansing, but not just in the body, right? We're talking about cleansing energetically. And don't you think we've really lost sight to that from natural medicine's point of view? Haven't we lost sight to the fact that it does more than just take care of the thing that ails us?
Yes, we have to go beyond that physical level and into the other dimensions. And that's really, that's what the indigenous tribes understand so beautifully. It's not just what we see. It's all that underneath it. We don't even realize that thoughts are energy. I mean, we talk about it, that thoughts are things, but we don't really truly understand
right.
that on a cellular level.
Right, we don't.
And I think what this beautiful medicine does is it gives us that experience of understanding the energetic body on a cellular level.
So what do you believe are going to be the greatest challenges
for bringing this to the
mm-hmm.
U.S.? Mostly people getting past their fear. That's generally a lot of the problems in our world is people just getting past their fear. And even though, I used to say I don't feel fear, but the reality of it was I just didn't feel. I had shut down all my emotional bodies, and underneath all that, there was a ton of fear.
Right, right. And, but, isn't that interesting that we do say that?
We do say that all the time. And I used to say it myself. And I remember the one year on New Year's where I was telling my friend that I didn't feel fear. Well, watch out what you say, because that year, I think every fear I had showed up. And, the universe was kind of showing me, you got some fear there. But I didn't know it. I had numbed myself out through all kinds of things, television, work, shopping.
TV will do it.
Absolutely. So we become so numb to actually what we're feeling that we don't even realize the things that are going on inside of us.
Wow. You know, this hour has gone by so very quickly, and I want to thank you. And we're going to be talking with you again. Again, tell people again about the workshop, when it is, where it is, how they can sign up, and how they can find out more. Let's send them to your website.
Fantastic. Well, the workshop is June 13th, 14th, and 15th. We have a beautiful location along the water here
nice.
In the Seattle area. Setting is very important. If you want information, you can go to my Facebook page called Cambo Kiss and like it, or you can go to www.cambo.kiss.com and send me a message. If you want information, I'll send back to you. You can register there. And we are really looking forward to this wonderful, wonderful, beautiful, loving medicine coming to the Seattle area.
I love it. Thank you so much for tuning us in, turning us on. We're going to take a short break, everyone. We'll be right back.
I tried to swim.